Hello, Mr. Nealon here. So we're back in Warcraft Total War version 2.2. So we're playing as a combined hotseat campaign where we're playing as both the Sindori, also known as the Blood Elves, and the Naga faction, also known as the Illidari or Illidan's Naga. Okay, we are currently in control of the Blood Elves. We are about to fight Artis Mantil in Northrend. I've fought this battle maybe 5 times already. I believe that first I played it offline when I we are processing a video, like in May, just for fun. So that was just a trial of the battle, see how it would go. Then I have played it many times over on my Twitch. Over on my Twitch, because I were trying to stream the game, first using Shadowplay, Nvidia Shadowplay recorder, and later using a tool or device that I bought, but the quality was horrible, so I decided to scrap my plans of streaming the game. Also, the material from Twitch disappears after a while, so none of the videos are still there. All of them have disappeared. I believe they were saved to my computer too, but they were so horrible in quality that I rather replay everything again. Okay, so we'll play this battle. We are controlling Helder on Brightwing, the General with his bodyguard of 126 Brightwing Vindicators, and we are reinforced by Captain Talorian, who has his army, 1544 men. We'll place them under AI control, but we will manually be able to give them orders. Okay, so command this army in battle means we will give them orders like aggressive stance, shootout stance, or defensive stance. Then we have an allied army, the remnants of Prince Kael'Thas' army. So he's king in this mod currently, but he is prince in lore. He never became king despite his father dying. I forgot about that. Okay, Captain Slayin, 726 men. He will have the same system. Okay, let's start the battle soon. We'll just check Arthur, so he is the only one with an army such as this, probably Sylvanas. Windrunner might also have that for the Forsaken. All the others had new armies with mostly basic troops, some medium troops, and very few elite troops. Okay, let's start the battle and fight this for the 6th or 7th time. Okay, so I always win because we have 2 armies, or 1.5 against 1, but sometimes my hero will almost die because Artis or the cavalry manages to ride straight to him. So we'll need to keep him out of that situation. We'll use the immersion mod. Okay, start deployment. So here we have Haldron Brightwing using a Sindori Swordmaster model because he is a Swordmaster in lore, and his bodyguard is made up of Brightwing Vindicators actually. Okay, our ally will come from this corner. We'll place him here. We have very good weather this time, I like it. Let's tab out for a second and go to mods and third person mod new and start the mod and return. Seems to be working. Start the battle and reinforcements. Captain Talorian and Captain Stayin are reinforcing us in the battle. First army has entered. We will place them on shootout stance. We don't want the phoenixes to charge in melee or any of the casters, if there are casters in his army. I think there are casters in his army. We are waiting for a second army to join as well. Here we have one of the armies entering. We have the Blood Blades. Sindori Swordmasters, they are named as Kael'Thas because they are also reskinned for the Kingdom of Kael'Thas. Or I mean, Kingdom of Kael'Thas. Okay, but they are, so it's a neutral name, but otherwise they are Sindori Swordmasters. Okay, Blood Traits, some Blood Traits here. Best looking female unit in the mod. Okay, and we have some small Brightwing Vindicators, heavy infantry, Arcane Guardians, smaller Giants. They count as infantry, not cavalry. But they are good against cavalry. Okay, and we have Spellbreakers, Spearmen. Some Casters, Arcanists, and Priests of the Sun. Some Archers over there, two units of Archers. Here we have a unit of Priests of the Sun, so we have two of them. More Archers, so three Archer units at least. Here we have Blood Mages, so General's Bodyguard. Or it's a unit of Blood Mages, I don't know. Oh, the Second Army Center, we'll place them in Route Out 2, that's the one with the Phoenix. You can see the Giant Phoenixes here, are about to enter. We also had a Remnant Bloodshed unit and some fresh units. Brightwing Vindicators, Blood Shades, and Sandore Swordmasters. Okay, we'll say Sandore Bloodblades. Even have a Remnant Hawkstrider unit, I believe. No Arcane Guardians, actually. Okay. And Haldron Brightwing.
For the moment, the fortune of battle goes our way.
So you can walk, of course. You can also run. Change to running. Move towards one of the armies. Follow the bodyguard. Zoom out a bit because the sword is really long. If you want to have the sword visible, you need to be zoomed out like this. We don't want to miss out on the action, so we'll try to reach our army that is closest to the enemy. Where it will take us. I don't want to face Arthas or any cavalry like the Crypt Lords or Death Knights. The hero I want to be behind our army and avoid the cavalry. Cavalry is the most dangerous unit against heroes. With the exception of casters, they are even more dangerous. The cavalry are really dangerous, and they usually attack the heroes too. Especially if they are dismounted. Okay. Sandhorn at the general. They stopped. Other arm has entered. See the blood blades here. Sandore Swordmasters. Blood Shades. The Brightwing Vindicators. Remnant unit of Spellbreakers. Here's the remnant unit of Hawkstrider Knights. Only three remaining. And two Blood Knight units too. With the three Phoenixes that we do not want to have to fight in melee. Because they will lose in melee. They are good as a ranged unit. They can use circle and shoot ability and fly around in a circle. Then move move away when the enemy gets close. We have the Arcanists, remnant units of Arcan Guardians. They have a unit of Arcane Guardians, two actually, Blood Shades, Doris Swordmasters, two units of Blood Blades, units of writing V indicators, one unit of Elven archers or just archers, priests of the sun, two at least, and then they had blood mages, a unit of them. I don't think they had a general. They had three units of archers, actually. Two units of the priests, one unit of arcanists, one full unit of spellbreakers. Bodyguard with the hero, so he won't get left behind. So the balance of power, victory is a distinct possibility. No one has died yet. The Scourge army is moving up, ever closer to our army. And it's led by Prince Artus, the Death Knight. Or Death Knight Artus. Okay. Battle started, the music changed. Good. Can't be that far away from the army now. I think they are very close. Our bodyguard will probably stop soon. Stop moving soon. Yeah, they stopped. Now they return, so the allies over there. Let's move forward, soldiers. Far forward. Don't want to miss out on the battle. But we will stop for a second. So to check the situation. Gargoyles fighting the Bloodblades. Here we have Bloodblades versus the cavalry. Death Knights. Don't know if Artus himself is over here. He's probably one of them. Here we have Death Knight unit. Don't know if Artus himself is in it. Should be in one of the Death Knight units, but I don't know exactly which one. Okay, we don't really like to run into these guys. Our Brightwing Vindicators are moving forward. Seem to be fired at from some Lich Mage unit. Here we have some Barons and Necromancers firing at us from the back there. Well, our Blood Shades are fighting there. Skeleton Raiders, Light Cavalry, and another unit of Death Knights here. This is the one with Artus himself. Death Knight Artus. The battlefield. Taking out an Arcane Guardian there, fighting the Brightwing Vindicators and some others. Okay, here they are, Myriarch Champion, Giants, fighting out Arcane Guardians. Their Giant Axes. Some Vargul. And undead trolls, orgul bone hackers. We have some undead trolls there too, yeah. Some abominations fighting our spellbreakers. We might lose this battle. Yeah, the archers have started to fire upon the enemy. Our mages have finally reached an area where they can fire at their mages. As far as I can see, they are being fired at from these liches here. Lich General's bodyguard. Or maybe it's just a unit in this army. It's Arthas army after all. They are killing our bright vindicators. Motion. So on, attacks the tool. Okay. Sending in skeleton archers. We have some crypt lords here too, fighting our infantry. Lore Swordmasters and Brightwing Vindicators. One of their cavalry units are moving up towards our bodyguard. That's what I was afraid of. They would charge us like that. Let's see here. The other side, our second army is yet to reach the enemy. They have some crypt lords over here. Back to our bodyguard. He seems to be charging with cavalry. See, an army, a unit of death knights. Soldiers, prepare yourself. Charge at the cavalry. Charge it with death knights. Spread out too, so I can move in.
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory.
Sound the horn. Good job, soldiers. Continue to fight the cavalry. Knew they would try to target the general, no matter where we are on the battlefield. The AI is not that stupid. You added a smarter AI to this mod, so they will try to take out generals, unfortunately. Yeah. So it seemed to be a pretty even battle between the first Blood Elven army and the Arthas army. We have their reinforcements coming in from the east. So with their reinforcements we should be able to win. We have lost, you can see, 38%, and they lost 30%. Okay. Somehow. Good job, soldiers. Continue to fight. Sidore. Slay this undead scourge. Sure, Arthas will pay for laying ruin to Kael'Thas previously. Okay, this Death Knight bodyguard is dangerous, so we'll try to stay away from him. But we could probably take out one of them. We'll attack automatically when we're close to him. And we have ordered a unit to attack. Yeah, took down one of the knights, another one. And that one too. Third one. Killed 44%. We killed 49%, I believe. I killed 46%. We are starting to take the lead. Good job, soldiers. Tide is turning. Kill 47%, I killed 50%. We They killed half our army. Sound the horn. 48%, 51%, shit. Good job, bodyguard. Continue to fight. I believe you will be able to win against this unit of Death Knights. I don't think they can win. We are too numerous. They won't get to. Percent enemies kill, 56% allies kill. On. The recording stopped, but now we are moving forward. We only lost a second or something. It's no big deal, but I need to be very careful with checking the corner here, so I don't miss out when that happens. It's very, very annoying when you record and it stops in the middle of the recording. Hate that. But if I can see when it happens, then it doesn't matter if I lose 1 second or two. So we have some cavalry over there. Let's move up the general's bodyguard. Okay, so we are not undefended here. The battlefield. Dangerous units over there, really fast gargoyles, I believe. They are super fast. They are weak, light cavalry, but they are super fast. And they fly. They can hunt down any unit, almost any unit. I believe they are one of the fastest units in the game, but the goblins have even faster units. They have motorbikes and rockets that are super fast, especially the rockets. Nothing beats the rockets. Okay, the motorbikes are probably the second fastest unit. Shit, here comes the gargoyles! He assaulted our bodyguard. Attack, bodyguard. Okay. They are pretty big, the gargoyles, when you see them up close like this.
To praise the day before sunset. But our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
All right, we will prevail in this battle. Good job, soldier. Bunch of gargoyles can't hurt us. They are just light cavalry, I believe. They probably had a good charge there. Right, we won against the gargoyles. We have some cavalry over here. That's our cavalry, that's good. Our leave blood knights.
We are blessed.
Oh, the enemy unit of a death dead. Knight unit.
We have sent
right here.
The idiot to hell.
Yeah, took him down. Good job, soldiers. General fallen, Artis Manitil is dead. We've lost 71% and they've lost 99%, so the battle is pretty much won. Good job, soldiers, you didn't disappoint. I actually thought this battle was pretty cool. Even if you didn't see Artis die. Good job, soldiers. You fought well today. We have defeated Artis and his army. Death Knight Artis is no more. We have some blood mages. They're dangerous prick time.
Fate has been kind to us and delivered us victory. It could easily have been us out there, slain and defeated on the field.
Alright, we won the battle. Close victory. Haldron Brightwing had 126 men in a bodyguard of Brightwing. The recording stopped again. When it's up there, I can see the when it happens. When it was down there, I couldn't really see it because it wasn't as visible. Okay, Captain Talorian had 1,544 men, lost 1,194, 350 remaining, 552 enemies killed. And Captain Slayen had 726 men, lost 224 men, 502 remaining, and killed 370 enemies. Artis Manitil, or Death Knight Artis, of the Scourge, had 958 men, lost, actually 988 men, lost 988. His army was strong. Stopped recording again. I hate why that happens all the time now. Artis is defeated. Okay, we're back on the map. Haldron Brightwing. Let's merge the army and move Haldron in as well. We need to merge the troops. We can move Haldron back into the army. Move them. Okay, end of turn report. Military, we are the 6th strongest faction in the world. Scourge is still the strongest militarily. Financially, the Legion has the best financial situation. We are at place 20 out of 20. I don't know, 22 maybe. Production. We are at place 20. The Scourge is the number one in both production. They have the best production. They have the largest population, which they should have. They are the Scourge, the undead. Unlimited numbers of zombies and skeletons, and then. Overall, the Scourge is the strongest faction still, okay. Enemy army routes, Haldron Brightwing, yeah. Trade increase, Haldron Brightwing, feels appreciated. Okay. So in Frosthold we have King Kael'Thas, we'll refer to him as Prince Kael'Thas, and we have a unit of Pyrestar Demolishers. You can move that unit down to the army. Haldron Brightwing has. We have a fleet moving up here. Let's fast forward. We have some frigates and elven destroyers. We have Hatun of Kveldanas inside of Ulduar. The unit of Spellbreakers in Tunkalo, a village. We are still minus in resources, we need to fight more battles with the army. We're moving back towards Frosthold and Prince Kael'Thas. And in the Eastern Kingdoms we have a spy outside of Heartglen, where we have Galvar Pureblood and an army of, I believe, Scarlet Crusaders. So they are still neutral. A Sandora diplomat here. Let's speak to the Scarlet Crusade. They have same enemies as we have. So we are at war with Asiel Nerub, just like them, and the Scourge, just like them. No, we are not at war with these guys, they are neutral. But we are at war with the Scourge, just like them. They are at war with the Naga, our ally. We still want an alliance if we can have that. Seems the case. Okay.
We cannot quite accept this.
He will agree to an alliance.
Seem you are very reasonable.
A Alliance announced, the Scarlet Crusade and the Sindore Blood Elves. Okay. Still it is seized, Scarlet Crusade and Naga. Oh, that's good. In the Northrend, they have a ceasefire now. Okay. Let's move our spy towards Lordaeron. Here we have the capital of the Forsaken. Inside of which we have Dark One Sylvanas, faction leader. The unique bodyguard. We also have Commander Varimatras, faction heir. Dreadlord bodyguard. We have some units including Abominations. Okay. They also hold Brill. They have another general. Charlindra. Banshee. Okay. Here we have an assassin. We're at war with the trolls. That sabotage their buildings. I believe it failed. No, sabotage means a success. Rahain of Eversong Woods. Trader. Destroyed the trader there. 100% destroyed. 50% actually. Okay. They do not have any money. Need to fight more battles. Can move this army against Sulmashar, held by the trolls. It's a troll settlement town. We'll move against that area next. Besiege it. Don't need any units in the fort. Let's move everyone. Besiege the city or town. We only have 4 units there. We can move an army back to the capital. With 2 units inside. Move another unit out to the army. I have 3 caster units inside of the city. Some cavalry can be moved in. So, Prince Lord Tamar, he needs to be, I believe, his battle model needs to be fixed. In the next update. So I've received an update by a guy named Trug on the Discord, and that update will add new artilleries and traits to the Warcraft of the War Reign of Chaos campaign, and new unit cards for new heroes for some factions on the map, and new heroes, family members, and some other stuff. So, and it will fix certain things, like for example the title of Kael'Thas, so it will be Prince Kael'Thas instead of King Kael'Thas. Okay. Believe we're done here. Can't attack this time. Do not have any money, we can click and turn, then we will check it. We have moved all our agents. So let's check the spy outside of Lordaeron, yes. Priest, we don't need to move it. We used assassin, we have a diplomat, we have spoken to the Scarlet Crusade this turn. We have a merchant, okay. So this faction, capital city is Uldar because I wanted the make sure it won't revolt, but otherwise the capital is of course Silver Moon, this settlement. Okay, and Prince Kael'Thas is the leader, and greatest general is Haldron Brightwing. No, Hatyon of Kaldanas is the greatest general. Okay, we have 5 generals, and the regions control 8. We have 3 castles and 5 cities. We have won 21 battles in the campaign as the Sindore or Blood Elves. We lost 0 battles. Year is 617. Turn number is 10. Which means we have played 20 turns because we are also controlling the Naga. Domination, hold 50 regions, including Tranquillian, Silver Moon, Sunwell, Fairbreeze. I believe we are holding all of them. Sunsail, Enchorage, and the Limnit factions, Lordaeron, Scourge, and the Amani. Okay. We have 147. No, we have 14,790 turns remaining. Okay. Let's end the turn. Now we're controlling the Naga faction. You can check them immediately. Capital city is Eldaret here. Faction leader is Demon Hunter Illidan. Greatest general is Demon Hunter Illidan as well. Generals 13. Regions controlled 8. Cities, I believe, 3. Castles 5. So the opposite of this, I'm sorry. Battles won 1. Battles lost 7. Okay, here is 617. Turn number 10. To win, we need to hold 50 regions and eliminate factions Lordaeron, Night Elves, and the Scourge. Okay. We are allied to the Tendore Blood Elves and to the Burning Legion. We are at war with the Rebels, the Amani, the Ankirai faction, Riku, the Scourge, Night Elves, Terramor, and Lordaeron. We do not have any borders with Lordaeron or with the Amani, so they are not an immediate threat to us. In Northrend, I believe we have a border with the Vriku, or we are in the same continent as the Vriku. And we are on the same continent as the Ankirai faction too, in Kalimdor, but both of these factions are far away from us. Then the Night Elves are our neighbor here, they are our main enemy in Eastern Kingdoms. And Terramor is another enemy we have in these lands. They are a bit away. And then Lordaeron, we have no border with them. The Scourge is our main enemy in the world, but also in Northrend. We have no immediate border with them. They are a bit away as well. Okay. Diplomatic information. Following factions have declared that they are allies. The Scottish Crusade and the Sundore, also known as the Blood Elves. And therefore the Naga have made a truce with the Scarlet Crusade. Relations worsened the Vriku. We have poor relations with the Vriku. Okay. The economy is better for the Naga. We have this giant trip here. Trip model. Giant Kraken. Let's check our constructions. It's in Blood Mist. Could actually go for some dirt roads to improve the economy. Okay, I think we are constructing almost everywhere. Yeah. Check the recruitment then. So in Eldaret, could recruit some troops. Go for snapdragons there. Okay. We don't need more than one. We might need more than one. We could leave a unit of Marlocks there, maybe. Okay, let's check other areas. Ruins of Metistra, they are under siege. We don't need to build anything there. I believe we could probably win the battle, so we will continue to construct this building. Maybe not. We will stop that. We'll get some money by stopping the construction. Okay. Nashivel, we will probably be attacked soon. We are building a bestiary of the shores. We'll continue to do that. Can't recruit any troops. In Solar Cell, we can go for some Murloc Swamp Runners. Blood Mist, can go for some Tide Hunters, Murloc Shore Crawlers. Don't need to build everywhere, recruit everywhere. Here we can go for some Saturn Shadow Stalkers. Okay. And we're done. the Night Elves will attack the ruins of Metistra soon. I have played this battle at least two times. First time I played it, it crashed in the late game, I believe. And then the second time it didn't crash. I streamed the second time. And I played it without recording the first time. It was part of that playtesting I did in May. Then I did the streaming in June or July. I believe July. The quality was so bad that I didn't want to keep it. And instead decided to replay. Okay, we could move out. There are rebels we want to destroy and conquer. So we have Visha here with a unique model.
Yes, Lord.
A unique
eyes,
Naga Sivich model, but also in use by the merchants. Then we have the Naga faction here, Lady Vash with a unique model here. Okay, we don't need a tower, I believe. Here we have their settlement. Kashgala, the only area in control by the, I believe the Tuskar. Their leader is here. Axilot. Okay, with the bodyguard of Tuskar long tusks. Their army shouldn't be far away. Here is the army. They've been nerfed. In the past they had an entire army, now they have just half an army. To start, okay. The Tuskar fishermen and the Tuskar long tusks and some other stuff. Okay. They might attack us the next time. We'll see. But I think the Night Elves will attack first, no matter what. Here we can recruit some Murlocs. Okay. So let's see if we have any agents we need to move. Merchants, we don't need to move them. Okay, end turn. And this battle is about to start. Okay. It's a very long battle, they have many armies. So I think we will end the episode here. So in the stream I played both of these episodes in one episode. I played what I have already played now and I played this battle too. But we will not do that here. We will save the game here. As we can see, by the way, they have total advantage. 1 to 15 advantage. So they are 15 times as numerous as us. But we have the castle. And we have a lot of casters and such. So yeah, it will be an interesting fight. Wait a second, this is just a unit outside of the city. A unit of Naga Sea Snakes. I think we will fight this battle. We'll save the game. And fight this battle as well. We are not entirely done with the hour. I thought this was the giant battle that would take forever to play, but it was just a smaller battle outside of the city. I believe the giant battle of the city can take over 1 hour to finish in real time. Let's start the battle. Lose formation, sound the horn. Now where's the enemy? They're over here. Let's just charge. The Night Elven army are marching up the mountain. They have some Night Elven volunteers, Night Elven swordsmen, Shadowland guardians, Night Elven spearmen. Night Elven archers. And some Night Elven cavalry. We have a captain and a unit of fresh unit of Naga Sea Snakes. Strong unit. Can't win on their own. Spawned outside of the city because we had a full garrison inside. Then they were attacked. Hey, by the way, could tab out, start this tool. I can zoom in. Can't control them because I did it too late. Can zoom in on the unit. Their glorious attack on the superior Night Elven force. We'll all die, but at least they tried. So we are in loose formation to avoid their arrows. Reach the enemy soon, or they should reach us. We can see them already. They're down there. Not the best battlefield. They mount. Sound the horn. And they are over us. I believe that they are actually huntresses. Yeah, huntresses. They are ranged units. So at least we start to attack them by clicking on them. Not the best, what should I say, camera. We have to zoom out. Fast forward. At least turn it into normal speed, no slow motion. Sound the horn, yeah, captain.
Our army is tiring.
So they had quite a few. This cavalry, and they have this infantry and archers too, charging us all over the map, all the way down. Okay, not a good camera. Let's close the program so we can fast forward. It's a boring battle with a bad camera. We lost the captain. Captain Atop died.
Pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat
seems killed 1% of their giant army. They've killed
we have lost half of our
64%
men.
Of our troops, as if we have 73%. We have been defeated.
We have been dealt a stinging defeat today.
Okay, clear defeat. We lost everyone. Killed 21 of them. Now we almost played for an hour. I believe we'll click next turn. Maybe that's what we did and they attacked. Okay. We'll see if they attack again and attack the city now. Or if they do not.
Hiding our forces from enemy eyes might very good.
Oh, they're still besieging the ruins of Metistra. Right, presented, betrothed, Daystrat, Dusk Queen, King Kael'Thas. Accept new mission. We wanted to speak to the Forsaken. Yeah, we can do that. Marriage, celebrations, King Kael'Thas and Daystrat, Sunstrider. Okay. Relations worsened, Lordran, we have poor relations with them. Relations improved, Naga good, okay. Trade increased, Hathion of Kael'Thas feels respected. End of turn report, same as before. We have a spy outside of Lordran. Our diplomat is getting closer, we won't reach them this time. Our assassin tried to destroy another building. I believe she succeeded. Destroyed the training grounds. They are 100% destroyed. Good job. Okay. So the army. It's revolted. It's time to take our capital. It's revolted. We're besieging, we can't attack this time. Inside we have some undead elven troops, elven swordsmen, arcanists, two units of hogstrider knights, one unit of elven silver guards, which is pikeman unit, and elven rangers. So undead versions. We are attacking Sulmashar. Okay, there is a small scourge on outside. Heldron Brightwing. Know where I want him to go next. Move to the back to the prince, maybe. And we moved everyone into Frosthold for now. You're still minus in economy. Can't do much more this time. We will have to wait a turn. But we will attack Sulmashar. We will end the episode here. They have four units here. One unit of Ammonition Champions Bodyguard. One unit of Ammonition Berserkers. Skirmisher units. Ammonition Savages. Another Skirmisher unit. I believe the Savages throw javelins. Giant javelins. And Berserkers throw giant axes. One-handed axes. And the Troll Tribesmen. That's their militia. Unit, giant troll militia unit, and of course it's better than the smaller trolls, but it's the worst one of the giant trolls. And then the bodyguard is an elite unit. Okay, let's save the game. Finally, we have overwritten this. Save. Alright, thanks for watching, and in the next episode we'll fight the Battle of Sulmashar against Amani as the Sindori elf, Blood Elves, and then we'll probably most likely be attacked by the Night Elves at the ruins of Metistra, so we'll fight that battle too. I've fought both of these battles previously, and I played in a stream. Okay, so we will replay that in the next episode. Thank you for watching, see ya.